Hey guys, I'm Michelle and I'm excited to bring you your thought of the day today. I've been thinking lately about what it means to shift into a new season, and I've been reminded of something that David Campbell said when he was here a few years ago. He was telling the story of Lewis and Clark and how when they were charting out this undiscovered land in our country, that they were rivermen and they used to travel along water, and when they reached the Rocky Mountains, they had canoes on their backs. And David Campbell was sharing about how what's brought us here won't bring us there. That as they're standing facing these mountains, they're realizing, oh, what's taken us here is not gonna take us there. And so I'm feeling from the Lord this invitation for all of us in this new season that we're in this new season that He's shifting us into, that what has worked before may not necessarily work for us in this new place. And I've been thinking about the passage in Joshua, when Joshua and the Israelites are about to cross over from one place in the wilderness, literally cross over the Jordan River and come into the promised land. And I feel like there's two keys for us that the Lord gave to Joshua and the Israelites that will also help us today as we're shifting and adjusting in this new space. So in Joshua 3, verse 2, it says, "At the end of 3 days, the officers went through the midst of the camp, and they commanded the people, saying, 'When you see the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord your God, with the Levitical priests carrying it, then you shall set out from your place and go after it. However, there shall be a distance between you and it of about 2,000 cubits by measure. Do not come near it, that you may know the way by which you shall go, for you have not passed this way before.'" And so our first key is to follow His lead. Here, there's a specific instruction in Scripture given to Joshua and the people that says, hey, you're about to go into a new place, and the Lord is saying, I want you to have the Ark of the Covenant, my presence, to be the thing that's before you. Wait for my lead. Wait until you see me go out first and then follow it, because you have not passed this way before. Oh, and I feel I like get so much comfort from that thought, that the Lord knows that we're in a place, in a time that we have not been before, but He's inviting us, He's promising us that He's gonna be the one that goes ahead. He's the one who goes before us and is gonna dispossess our enemies before us, but we need to fix our eyes on Him and let Him lead the way, and then we get to follow. The second instruction that the Lord gave to Joshua is from Joshua 3, verse 5. It says, "Then Joshua said to the people, 'Consecrate yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you.'" And so for us today, I'm feeling the second invitation and key from the Lord is to consecrate yourselves. Consecration at this time was a beautiful ritual of purification and cleansing. It was like a literal washing, like wash and cleanse yourselves. And He's saying here, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. Consecration looks like becoming holy and getting rid of anything that doesn't look like the Lord. And so the Lord's been doing this with me in my life personally. In our home, it's looked like spiritual and natural things. So like getting rid of clutter, getting rid of things that I don't want to take with me into this new season. So Lord, what are those things? Self-sufficiency, that hasn't really, it's taken me to a point, but it's not going to take me any farther. Being hard on myself. Jeff's been talking about listening to accusations. That may have worked for a while, but that's not going to work for us in this new space. And so the Lord is inviting us, consecrate yourselves. I'm reminded to guard my heart, guard my influences. What am I watching? What am I listening to? And consecrate those things. He's making us holy, and it's all preparation to meet with Him. So I hope that encourages us today. I love you guys. I miss you so much. And Father, would you just bless each person watching right now? I thank you, Lord, that even in a place where we may not know the way, God, that you are the way and you promise to go before us and you promise to make us holy like you are holy. So Lord, I just ask for your help, Holy Spirit, that you would come and be helper with this process as we're adventuring together. And I just thank you for your constant presence. Would you bless each one now in Jesus' name? Amen. Mwah.